One thing that really struck me was as you go through and you talk to dozens of people in the film, you kind of make it very clear that they had this false sense of security where somebody came in, tested their water. They were under the assumption that it was clean because, as you said, they were running the water beforehand, which isn't an accurate way to test it. And then you kind of see on their faces the looks of just horror when they realize, wow, I've been drinking this water, I've been using this water, and it isn't actually safe. And part of the story that was really gut-wrenching for me is when you were talking to people and you were detailing, or really they were detailing, how much medical issues they were having. And one anecdote that really stood out for me was when you spoke to a woman who had recently moved to Flint. She had her daughter there. She was showing all the rashes that the water caused. She had sickle cell anemia and she was in and out of the hospital. And to me, that one really stood out because it shows not just how damaging the water is on their bodies, but how quickly it happened. Like, she was there for a couple of months and all of these medical issues kind of bubbled up to the surface that maybe they were already predisposed to have certain issues, but to see how quickly the water made them worse, it was horrible. So can you talk a little bit about the medical issues that people were having? Because obviously I'm just kind of pulling out one example, but there was another lady who was experiencing, it wasn't epilepsy, she said, I believe, but she was experiencing seizures and they were treating her as if she had epilepsy. And this was all presumably because of the water. So can you talk about some of these medical issues that people have been telling you they've experienced because of the water?
Yeah, and I want to make clear the most striking thing that I want people to know, hopefully when they watch the documentary, that mother you told me that you were referencing with the daughter sitting on her lap that had the white blisters all over her arms and legs.
In her ears. That was
right. They had just moved into that home in May 2018. She had clear skin. It was within 2 weeks, really, that she had white blisters. This was 1 month after Governor Snyder, now former governor, declared the water restored. So what we're trying to show in this documentary is, you know, a one-year-old baby after a few weeks in a home is not getting white rashes and blisters from watching television. The mother bathed her for almost 30 minutes because they told her her water was fine. So I think what the documentary will show is we're not talking about the carnage and the disaster that happened 5 years ago. It's still, people are still actively having these rashes. You see people losing hair, people getting nosebleeds, autoimmune issues, this and that. But I think what people will see from the documentary is because of the false sense of security. One woman, Amanda Jane, she was 35. She was the one I was talking to on the porch who was in chemo. She never had a health problem in her life, like a cold once in a blue moon, but that's it. She was drinking the water, and then, you know, it became a national headline, so she stopped for a little bit. A Department of Environmental Quality official comes to her home, runs her water for anywhere from 30 seconds to a minute. She doesn't know anything. She doesn't know any better. They were just, like you said, happy that people came to test the water. She gets a slip in the mail, no lead. So she goes back to drinking it without a filter because some fixtures, filters don't fit over because it's an old faucet or whatever. So she had no filter on, and even people who drink with a filter have still had problems. But because she got that slip of paper from the state environmental agency saying, you know, no lead detection. Well, they probably got that because they ran her water. So I'm not a doctor. I can't say definitively this, you know, X caused Y, but never had a health problem. Say, in 2016, she gets spots on her kidneys. A few weeks later, she's having heart palpitations, severe fatigue. They find spots on her thyroid. Then it's diagnosed as thyroid cancer. So again, she has no family history for thyroid cancer. Her doctor said potentially it could have started in your kidney, which lead affects your kidney and moved to your thyroid. So you have resident after resident, including children, who, because the water was declared safe and they shut down the water pods based on this declaration, they can't afford to go buy bottled water cases and cases because most of them are poor. There's also a lot of people without transportation in Flint. So they're drinking from the tap because it's declared fine. Well, if the testing, if that declaration is based on the manipulated test that we found, well, they could potentially be drinking contaminated water still. And that's what I think people need to see. I think the other part of the documentary that's more human interest, like you said, I mean, you have people with learning disabilities now, children. You have people really with learning, delays, children who forgot the alphabet, used to be able to count to 30, now stop at 12.
Yeah.
The one-year-old that you were describing used to say mama, now says vava.
Right.
It wasn't shown in the documentary, but I know people still having nosebleeds. I know people, and Jen and I, we were stunned, Mike. We would go, we really canvassed. We hit 450 doors. Almost every block we went, we would find, you knock on one door, they're not home. Somebody else answers, you ask, oh, do you know if that person's coming home tonight? What time they usually get home? Because maybe we'd come back. They say, oh, they just died. We're not talking like senior citizens. You're talking people 40s, 50s, 60s. So this is, it's unfortunately been a silent, continual crisis that's been silent because our corporate media is a bunch of propagandists who, have basically created a new Cold War. And really, even before that, they stopped covering this because once Trump came down that escalator, it was, that was it. But you have this happening, and I want to be clear. This kind of stuff is happening in other cities, too. They're gaming the water testing in other cities. And it's really, at a certain point, it's kind of like, I don't want to be too strong, but it is, in a way, kind of murderous. You're intentionally testing the wrong way, giving people false numbers. It's actually a crime to falsify a federal regulatory compliance test. You're giving people false numbers, and then they're drinking the water and potentially getting lead. They had bacterial issues with the water in Flint that wasn't, they only focused on lead, most of the headlines. But there was bacteria, there were TTHMs, which are cancer-causing chemicals. God knows what else. So it's really horrifying, and I think what else is horrifying beyond just Flint is this was done really just brazenly. The state environmental officials were going into these homes testing the wrong way, and they did it because they probably didn't expect anyone to actually follow their steps and knock on doors and talk to people. So that's why I always tell my viewers, listen, corruption, it's not easy to find, but it's also not so hard to find because most corrupt agencies, individuals are sloppy. Who's going to investigate them? Brian Williams? like Anderson Cooper. So they don't expect anyone to look. But I think if you watch this documentary, I hope that people see. The best example is my younger brother. He's not really into politics. He's a good guy, but he's just not in our space. So he doesn't really watch. He watched yesterday. He texted me, I cannot believe this is happening in America.